Hey guys, Minecraft here, and welcome to another Minecraft tutorial. Now today I'm going to be showing you how to do T flip-flops. Now there's different types of T flip-flops, and I'm going to go from the original ones back in the day of just redstone, no pistons, to more recent ones, which are a lot more compact and a lot more efficient. Of course, ones in 1.3 are going to be totally different using the dispensers, but I won't go into those ones since 1.3 isn't out yet, and so far I've only seen one design, which is a really, really good design, but it's not my own. None of these are my own, I must add that. I don't know whose these are. These have been around for ages, so long in fact that I think no one really knows who originally designed it. But yeah, I'll link the one for 1.3 in the description. It takes you to a YouTube channel where the guys who created it. It's a really good design, so heading over there after you watch this video if you want to see 1.3 using dispensers. So here we have one of the original ones. This is the days before pistons. I just put a piston in here for the purpose of demonstration, like for output, but these are the days before pistons. Everything was a little bit bigger back then. You press a button, it will create one output. One again creates a different output. Now, if people don't know what a T flip flop is, it's basically making a button command into the same as a lever command. So, when you turn lever down, obviously it activates. When you push up, it deactivates. Same with the button, it just basically makes that principle as a button. So, when you press it once, it activates. When you press it again, it deactivates. And that's what a T flip flop is. So, this one goes into a AND gate and then into a memory cell, which creates the output. And it's a really nice design for when we didn't have pistons and stuff like that, so it is pretty decent. But yeah, a bit big. As time progressed, we got things a little bit more compact floor-wise, but things got a bit raised higher. Same principle again, though. You have a AND gate and a kind of memory cell to create the output here. So I'll do that. It goes up, press it again, it goes down. Once again, really nice and all that. Didn't use pistons, but at the same time it wasn't the compactest thing ever. So after that we got pistons, and these ones are insanely compact, as you can see. So what I'll do is I will get a repeater and a piston, and blue wall. Okay, and then if we go to the output, actually no, there's a red dot there, so it's fine. Just put the output and a bit of blue wall on top. As you can see, press down. Oh, maybe not. I need to put a repeater there after all. There we go. There we go. So down, up, down. Now, I will show you how to make these ones. I'm not going to show you how to make the older ones because I don't see really much point, but I'll show you how to make all the new ones using pistons. So the first one, we'll need some wool, different colours. So pistons, a repeater, a redstone, and a redstone torch, and a button. Okay, we've got everything we need. So I love that pick command, it's a beautiful addition. So for this one, all you need to do is you put a piston facing this way, a block, redstone torch, another block, piston, outputs here, put a torch, another wall, and a bit of redstone there, and you're done. Oh, and a button, of course, there. One, on. So put a repeater there and a wall block up top like that. You'll see. Off and on. It's a really nice design, really compact. It uses a one tick pulse which pushes this piece of wool along, and because of a one tick pulse, when the piston's out there, it spits the block out and then retracts. So it creates like a T flip flop. So you got that. Like that. Okay, so let's move on to the next design. This one is the classic design. This offers a little bit more, which I'll go into in a bit. But basically, two pistons pushing a block, and the output is a torch that's underneath here, right there. And I've just got the output there. So we click this, goes down. The block is not on top of the torch anymore, so the power's not gone. Click again, goes up, and you start. So that's the T flip flop here. Now this one, as I say, offers a bit more. So you can have two torches, so one there and one there, creating two individual outputs. So we click that now. Left one goes up. Or right one goes up in. Left one goes up. Right. Left. Now I'll go and show you how to make this one as well. So do piston, piston, dig two down. Depending on if you want two outputs or one output, we'll do for two. We just put torch there, wool block, and two walls on top, and a torch there, and redstone across the top. And then your outputs are there and there. I just put them into some wall blocks with the pistons on top, demonstration purposes. And a button there, and you're done. Off, well, left, right. Now, as I say, if you don't want two outputs and you just want the one, just get rid of torch and that, and you're done. That's it, really. Everything should work perfectly. So off, on. Really nice design, really compact. It's one I always use when I'm doing anything with redstone, pretty much. I might start using this one a bit more. It is a really nice design. It's just that this one offers a bit more in the way of outputs, so I like to use this one. But yeah, so that's the other design. So we have this one, which is a four-way T flip-flop. Now this one, I don't know if I haven't seen it around on the net before, so I'm not sure if it's been around for a while or what, but I know it, but I don't know how I know it, so I don't know if I came up with it. I'm not sure if I did. I strongly doubt I did. I might have just done it by accident, but yeah, I've not seen it, and I can't remember where I've seen it, if I have seen it. So if someone has created it, I'm terribly sorry. I'm not stealing the design. I say it right now. I don't know if I have created it or if I haven't created it. If I have created it, fantastic. If I haven't created it, then all credit goes to the original designer. But basically, this one has four outputs. You press the button, that one goes up. Press the button, that one goes up. Oh, bit of a Optifine glitch there. Still there. There it is. Press the button, goes up. And press that button, goes back to the beginning. Like that. So this one has torches underneath all the bottom and a block that is rotating around the bottom there. So I'll show you how to make this one. So if we go over here, so you want to start big, a 4 by 1 hole. Put torches on the bottom, a block of your choosing, piston, 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 and piston. And wall on top of that, or block of your choosing, and fill the top with redstone. Put a torch there, 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 and there. Your outputs are next to the pistons on each side, so there, 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 and there. There it is, and then block above it, or you can put the button on the side there if you wanted, or on top here, or any way you want it to do, as long as you get the output, as long as the input is this bit here. And you click the button, and the wool will move around with each press, moving the output to different areas. So if I put buttons on all the sides, see, goes to this one, goes to that one, and back to the start. So yeah, really nice design, really useful if you're having multiple outputs for anything really. But yeah, another T flip flop, four-way T flip flop. So the last couple here, they're just single ones, nothing too spectacular, a little bit like the first one, using a monostable circuit, which is here, to create an output. So we press a button, piston goes up, press the button again. And go back. Now, as you can see, as I say, it is a monostable circuit because when you push the button, the piston spits the block out, which has a torch into there, powers this repeater, and pushes the block up. Turns again, pulls the block in. So this one's really easy to make as well. Let's go over here. Dig two, dig one, put a torch, repeater set to 3 ticks, piece of redstone, block of your choosing, and bit of redstone there. Oh, sorry, not piston. Torch. That's what I meant. And then piston, the block, and then, oh, no, sorry, torch here as well. Then your block. And then your output is right here. I'll just do a piston with the block, blue block again, demonstration. And then your button there. That's it. So you have off and done. Off, done. Now, I've done it there, but you could have it anywhere really. But yeah, so actually no, you couldn't. Or actually, could you? Because the redstone's there. But nevertheless, that one works. So you just press that button, goes down. Press it again, goes up. Really nice design. Really compact again. Just depends on what you're needing. They obviously you've got four. You've got two options. You've got one option. This one's a one option as well. It just depends on speed and compact ability or compactness, I guess. This final design. Oh, was that with the final design? Oh, sorry. I just realized that one is that one. Yeah, this one is the one I just made there. So, if you want that one, it's this one. This one is a bit different, actually. This one is the one I just came up with off the top of my head, and I thought it was that one. Okay, so we'll do this one now. This one is what I showed you a second ago. So, same idea, monostable circuit again. I can't believe I actually screwed that up a little bit. Okay, so we'll do a monostable. So we need, I'm trying to think here. Oh yeah, okay. So we want to put block. I use orange because I like using orange for blocks. Block, block, repeater, set to 3 ticks. Torch, torch, redstone across the top like that. Piston there. Block of your choosing. Outputs here. Like that. Piston. Oh, piston. Blue block. And button. And you're done. Really simple. Really quick. Really easy. So yeah, those are the designs. I hope you find them useful. What I could do, actually, what I will do is I will put this map inside the description, so you can go and download it if you want and test, look at all the designs and check them out. Hope you sh if you did like this video, be sure to get that button a like, and if you find it useful, be sure to share it. If you haven't subscribed already, subscribe. I do these videos quite frequently, be it Let's Plays or tutorials or mod reviews or Seed Show, Seed Sundays. So I do lots of stuff. So be sure to check us out if you like my work. And yeah, I shall sort you all again soon. So until then, TTOL, peace out, and bye. Toodles. Bye bye.